December 6th, 1943. A group of B-24 Liberators take off from Hammer Field in Fresno, California on a rescue mission to find a Liberator which went missing the day before. The Liberator at the end of the formation veered off to begin a search pattern over the Sierra Nevada mountains and began to have mechanical trouble. Six young men died that day. The crash of the Huntington Liberator has become a legend to local residents. Talk to anyone in the area, and the conversation usually goes to the story of the 100-foot bomber at the bottom of the lake. It was assumed that the plane made a crash landing on Huntington Lake. Debris was found floating on the water, but numerous attempts to find the plane produced nothing. Local residents were surprised in 1955 when the plane became clearly visible, sticking up out of the water after the lake was lowered for dam repairs. The U.S. Army Graves Registration Service recovered the bodies of the six airmen that died, and some of the aircraft was salvaged at that time. There have been numerous attempts to salvage the aircraft since then. Some parts of the aircraft have been taken out, and it is not known what remains. Recently, a group of local residents went down to the Liberator to determine what is left. The task of finding the plane was made easier by using photographs taken in 1955 to locate the crash.
Pit bottom, and it's rocky.
Can you make out anything besides rocks?
No. Sun rays guide the way during the deep descent. Alien as any celestial landscape, what do we truly know of the secrets this place holds? How many have passed over, hundreds of feet above, unaware of what the depths hide? Finally, the deep reveals its mysteries. Twisted metal is found strewn across acres of lake bottom, indicating the crash was extremely violent, breaking the plane into countless pieces. Survival was not possible. Now that the crash site is located, the dive team discusses where to dive with the mini-sub. It is decided to dive near the cockpit location. No past attempts to salvage the cockpit are known, and there should be a considerable amount of wreckage in that area. The stakes for this dive are high and the team is nervous. The mini sub has never been tested at the depths required to reach the cockpit, and there is a risk of failure. Shapes appear in the distance. Excitement is high on the boat as the shapes look like wreckage, but closer examination reveals mangled trees. Articles that have been written about the crash state that Captain William Darden thought that he was landing on a frozen meadow, but interviews with the survivors after the crash say that the lake was not frozen over at all. After the plane began to have mechanical trouble, Captain Darden ordered the crew to open the bomb bay doors and bail out. Two crew members, Lieutenant Kunos Settle and radio operator Sergeant George Berlick, parachuted to safety. The other six crew members took their chances with the icy lake. Since the bomb bay doors were open, water immediately entered the fuselage, causing the plane to break into three large pieces and sink on impact. As sections of the nose come into view, it is clear that we are not the first to visit. Sensitive pieces of the plane are missing, including the guns and bomb sight, indicating that the nose could have been salvaged in 1955 by the Army when the bodies were removed. A large salvage operation to raise the plane was undertaken in 1980. Due to problems with the project, records on what was taken out of the lake are limited. It is known that one wing and two engines were removed. According to the salvage company, a large part of the fuselage was lifted off the lake bottom, but lowered back down and abandoned when financial problems terminated the project. It is not known who salvaged the cockpit and nose sections. It could have all been taken out in 1955. Were the guns taken at that time, or did scavengers find some way of taking them from the lake? We came to answer mysteries surrounding the crash, but find more unanswered questions. And now it's time to leave the Huntington Liberator, as we found it, a memorial to the young men who lost their lives here. Captain William Darden, Lieutenant Samuel Schlosser, Sergeant Richard Mayo, Sergeant Franklin Neiswanger, Sergeant Richard Lee Spangle, and Sergeant Donald Vanderplash. The mysteries of the Huntington Liberator will live on. The crew, that day, and their story will never be forgotten.